being a theme is your people do.
Uh-huh. Okay. Welcome to Straw Family Farm. I'm Christy.
I'm me.
Yeah, he's RJ.
Right.
Alright, in the chapel.
Be strong and courageous, for the Lord will be with you wherever you go. Joshua 1:9.
Awesome.
I don't know.
Are you sure you haven't used that one already?
I don't know. I may have. That's a good one.
Alright, in the barn stalls. Had a lot going on. You had a pretty scary morning when I was at work one morning.
Yep.
Let's just start there.
Dirt had, sometime in the night, taken and I guess reared up and stuck a foot over the gate and it slipped off and in between the gate and the pole that the gate hangs on. So, his foot was hung up in there. I had to get him out. And
I'd already left for work.
Yeah. His knee's pretty swollen after I got him out. And so, we've got him locked up in a little stall.
Okay, so. And it's the same leg that he had the foot infection in, correct? So, the one thing that we're going to have to watch is make sure that nothing settles in his knee. No infection or anything like that. Mm-hmm. So, right?
Mm-hmm.
And is it hot to the touch?
Mm-hmm.
So, that's how you watch for infection, is if it feels warmer than the skin around it, that's a sign of infection. So
mm-hmm.
We're touching it every day. What else? He's got some cuts. He tore up the back of his leg pretty good. Nothing that I don't think won't heal, but you're doing what to it? Mouthful.
Mm-hmm. Underwoods.
He's using what's called Underwoods, and it's weird because it is an Oklahoma-based company. It's not widely known. But it is it's liquid and black and you have to shake it to get it to mix together and then you spray it on and then take baking powder and put it on there, but you don't clean the wound. It literally makes it like an instant scab, and over the course of about 10 days you'll see something heal super fast. We've done it with dogs, sheep, goats, no cats, the horses. When we first had Angel and she sliced her head open all the way down to her skull, that's how it was treated and it did not leave a scar. So it's a highly guarded recipe, and it's a local, it's Oklahoma based family, and they won't let you know what's in it. So there's no ingredients listed on it.
It has some, but it's very generic.
Yeah. But anyway. So it's an amazing product.
Mm-hmm.
Cinder had her babies. I don't know if we did that last week or not. No. She's the last one. So lambing season's officially over, isn't it?
Yep.
Yeah. Cinder is always the last holdout. The last possible day she can give birth, that's when she can give birth. So, yep. Anything else? I turned Biscotti out. I turned Biscotti out of the barn with her one with the gimpy leg, and it's doing much better. It's getting around more. The older it gets, the stronger that leg gets. And she's doing good. She's doing good. If she goes back to limping, I will make sure they go in the barn. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I got me a boyfriend. I'm in love with this guy. I want a halter break and put him in the petting zoo. Now, the only reason I'm laughing, that's funny. RJ, how much does this guy weigh?
He's 1,400 pounds, probably.
He is a huge, huge longhorn. If you have not seen, please pop over to Facebook. And I'll see if I can find a picture, and if I can, you'll see it right here. If I can't, then you didn't see anything. But he's got these huge horns, and oh my gosh, he's amazing. You can't touch him yet, though, can you?
No.
But you can be in the pen with him. He's not aggressive, he's not wild, right?
Right.
But he's amazing. And he's white, so everybody that, the lady that had him before, she called him Whitey. And, okay, I was raised that that's a derogatory statement. It's just not something you call something. We have this discussion all the time. And I don't approve of that name, that word. It can be derogatory, so therefore we don't use it. So I changed his name to Bear. Because he's just like a big old teddy bear, ain't he?
Mm-hmm.
So he's really sweet. He does not come close. He's got a friend out there right now that's being weaned for a friend. She was having trouble. She's got a cow that's due to calf out. And this old bottle calf was sucking and taking colostrum. And she didn't want it to jeopardize the new calf's survival. So we have it here, that way she can't stop me. But we just put it in with Bear. And Bear is so sweet. I tried to get some video yesterday of him meeting the two baby calves that are on the outside of the fence. And he'd sniff them, and then he'd lick. And it was just too funny. But I screwed up my camera, and I couldn't get it. It kind of was terrible. I wanted it so bad. But the two baby calves are two bottle calves. Is that a cat I heard scream?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Our two bottle calves are just in awe of him. And they look so tiny next to him. And they've grown a lot, have they not?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they're like, but he just makes everything look so tiny. I look tiny in front of him. But he's awesome. He's amazing. And one of these days I am going to get to be petting on him. I don't know about putting him in a halter. Maybe a bull ring. Because he is huge. And then we could take him to the petting zoo with a bull ring on. Right? It's either that or halter breaking. At 1,400 pounds, I don't think there's even a post out there that can hold him.
No. With time to the donkey.
I don't think our donkey could pull him around.
I don't know.
And I don't think I have a halter long enough that he could drag the ground and him just train himself. We'll see. I don't know that I'll be able to get it done, but that's, it's kind of like that pipe dream that really won't come true. Anyway, so, alright, anything else in the barn stalls? Not really. No other injuries, no other animals in. Yeah, there's another donkey looking, he's here temporary, but I think we talked about him last week. I really got to start writing stuff down again. We talk about him?
No, we can talk about him.
We've got a donkey who's here temporary until he finds a new home.
Hey, we'll get you till Monday.
Yep. So, he's a mini Jack, just like Murphy. And if you were to put him and Murphy together, they would fight. So, he can't stay, but the guy needed him gone. So, it was an issue. So, it is what it is, right?
Can you imagine for a mini donkey?
Yes, give us a holler. He's not as tame as Murphy, but he's getting there.
Mm-hmm.
He's not wild, so. Mending fences, anything break down that you have to fix? We have a fence, a gate that,
the dirt was hung in.
Yeah, that he was hung in it. Bees in the top. We really don't have to fix it, but we probably will. What else? You pig. Say, excuse me.
Excuse me.
What else like mending?
Buttercup.
What about mending fences?
We fixed that thing.
What?
One that goes vroom vroom. My truck. And that needed a
one
washer.
Okay, it was a very important washer.
Yeah.
It kept the main fuse box. It was the washer that secured the main fuse box into the wiring. So none of the fuses were working. It was zapping the batteries because it was loose and shorting out. So it's the main wires that go up into Not the fuse box in the dash, not the little one that doesn't matter, the one underneath, I call it the brain, but I know that there's another part called the brain, but there's another fuse box underneath the hood, which has really important stuff in it.
Has big fuses.
Yeah, and he's got some other things up there. So relays, there's relays under there and some fuses and all that. So it had gotten loose and those wires coming up into the box where those relays and fuses are located was not making good connection. So that was the problem. And it needed a washer to tighten up where it screws in so that it all stayed together. We wouldn't have found that one. We had help. A paid mechanic.
Right,
let's
see
here. Lawnmower.
Oh yeah, we fixed the lawnmower.
Yep, got one up and running. I've got another one that's got to go to the guy, but the Cub Cadet has got to go to the lawnmower guy. Mm-hmm. But my lawnmower guy, his wife was in the hospital. Her kidney stones or gallstones, I can't remember. She's up in Tulsa. So I told him to take care of her first and give me a call when that got straightened out, and I would definitely have him fix that. He said okay. So it's not fixed yet, but it's going to. In the yarn farm.
Nothing.
Shearing sets to finish up hopefully this week, correct? This coming week. So I'll get to washing fleeces and that kind of stuff. In the field. Oh, my garden.
They goated everything in it.
Stupid. Okay, so doofus.
Festus,
whatever. He's back in the dog pen.
He can't get out.
He can't get out of that one. I put him in the man pen. He can get out of that. He can get in my garden. He literally climbs the gate like a ladder and jumps over.
Or he just runs and jumps.
And if he can get a running start, he can clear it. Including the beast with the barbed wire, which is crazy. So, anyway. My peas, I planted them. I had them on my strings. They were going up the new trellis. The goat ate them. The marigolds by the swing. I have beautiful pictures. One side, the goat ate it. What else? I had to replant some things.
So you just pulled them out.
Because he just, yeah. I guess he doesn't like rosemary. Just saying. Not in his palate. I don't know. My bell pepper plants, bit them off. I mean, there's like 3 leaves on each one. That's it. Ironically, he never makes it back to RJ's strawberries. He would take it seriously if it got to his strawberries. Yeah, look at that face.
Maybe I'm just lucky that way.
No. Anyway, so
maybe
I have zucchini.
Like
I got. I did buy some asparagus. Asparagus is an annual. I'm not eating anything out of it for 2 years, but I planted a row of asparagus. Just like 6 plants, and I'll let it take over. It's kind of like my kind of gardening. I'm just going to leave them there for, I don't know, 2-3 years. Because you can't harvest this year, and you won't get to harvest, I don't think, next year. I think it's the following year that I'll get to harvest. So, what do you do? Get off me. Anyway, so I probably won't get to harvest that. I've got zucchini in the ground, 4 plants. You know I'm going to have zucchini at the wazoo again. That's okay. I'm going to find some new recipes for zucchini. What else? What else did I plant?
Some plants.
Got some watermelon plants to get out. I've got some small tomato plants to get out.
We don't care. You're bored. Let's go on.
Fine. My herb garden's doing good too.
Yeah. Garden over.
No. What else did we get laid out and what came in the garden?
I was trying to skip over this.
In the field. Nobody
cares.
Nobody cares
about
yes, they do.
Nobody cares about it.
Yes, they do. Okay, no, so, finally.
If I don't get with the post, does that mean I don't have to dig the holes?
Well, you just have to get the post Monday, okay? You don't have to do anything and then we'll figure it out on Wednesday and I'll start digging. Okay, so.
Mm-hmm.
Just remember, once we get that shell up, you're done. So, I ordered the wood 2 weeks ago, and all this week, RJ has called and said, the 5x5s were supposed to be in, where are they, you know, what were you told, son?
They're not in.
They're not here. They're not.
Friday.
Friday, I got mad, and I called up there, and I talked to the owner, and I said, look, a week ago, I ordered 10 foot, I said, I ordered 8 10-foot 5x5s. And I said, my son has called every day this week. He says, they've been here since Tuesday. I said, then why have I been told that they're not here? He goes, I don't know. He says, they've been here since Tuesday. He said, I went and personally picked them up for you. He said, I thought it was odd that you didn't come get them Wednesday. I was mad. I was furious. So, I tried to go get them yesterday. That did not work out. Trailers got a flat. Tires got to be changed. Can't get tires off. I just bought some new tires. I don't even know how I got a flat. Anyway, RJ ends up taking my truck. The other truck, his truck, doesn't have a bed on it, so they can't just lay it on the thing. I have to take the flat bed, which needs. We have the two tires. We just have to get them changed off, right? So I couldn't go get them. I called him Saturday and I said, look. He goes, he just answers the phone. You're late. I was like, no, I'm not. I said, I don't have a way to come get them today. I said, I thought I was going to. I said, RJ has my truck. The truck I have has no bed on it. And I said, and I was going to take the flatbed trailer. We can't get the tires off to get them changed. So until the guys get home and get this put together for me, I can't come get him. I said, can I come get him Monday? And he goes, yeah. He gave me the total. He was just laughing because now it's been another week and I could have had him here. I could have been working on it this weekend. You guys could have seen actual footage. But what did I do? Instead, I have it all set out, right? Marked out.
We had a wing rush.
Yes. What did we do?
Burnt the junk down in
the brush pile. I burnt it, and I burnt it all the way down, and I'm going to take a magnet over it, make sure I get all the metal out of it. I found two little metal plates in the junk, in the brush pile, and I am not sure where they came from or what they are.
They were stuck on a piece of wood. I told you that.
Okay, what kind of wood?
There's a literally flat piece of wood. It was cut the exact size as the plate, stuck in between them.
I don't know. Anyway.
Oh, I know what it came off of.
What?
A thingamajigger.
Anyway, so I've got to take the metal. Sometimes the fence posts that break off will have wire on them, nails on them, anything like that. We burn it down to ash, and I mean white ash, powder ash, don't I? And then I take the big magnet, take it over it, and get everything out of there. So, all right, moving on in the farmhouse. Do you have to get a weed eater line?
You need me. That's it. There's some cats. We all love cats. I woke up the cats in my bed.
Yes, the kittens now have started.
I woke up and he was here.
He's got one. There's actually two of them, and I think he interchanges them as buddies. And they may end up staying here. I don't know.
My old buddy has learned to crawl in my bed.
He has learned to get to RJ at all costs. Now,
he tried to climb my legs the other day. When I changed him from my pajama pants to my real pants, he tried to climb me. That does not work.
Well, it worked just fine for him, just not for you.
Yeah, he made it like to my kneecap, and I was like, oh, hi, little fella, how are you? Yeah.
So, but yeah, so RJ's got.
I don't mind it when I have my pants on, because I have those little kitten claws, you can't feel them.
Yeah, on your you jeans.
Yeah, my jeans, but I didn't have any pants on, and that was skin.
You just hear RJ go,
He started doing it to you yesterday.
He did. I had on my capri pants, and I had passed through there and dropped off his laundry, and then took mine on it. And when I stopped to put his laundry down, it started to, and I was like, no. And off I went. So, alright. How's your rope? That's really the last thing. I don't have anything on the porch. I've been spinning some.
Alright, we placed one radio out of three. So.
What about the one you had a 13 in? Did it make?
I don't think so. Haven't seen anything.
Haven't seen any results?
No, I don't think I did, but.
He was placed in second, and then they changed the arena in the middle of performance, which you're not supposed to do. So.
Yep.
Anyway, alright. I've just been spending, I've got some camel from a friend. I got a hole in my hat that I made, and so I asked her to get me some more camel. She had some on hand. We did some wheeling, dealing, trading, and I have some more camel to spin. I love my camel. I love it. You can override on me. So, what's on the game plan for today?
I had to work.
Yep, and I got a weedy. I mowed. I've been keeping the garden mowed, and up here on the front of the house. But I had no weedy. Are you gonna show him this weedy line?
Oh yeah, where's it at?
Right there. Oh. He went and picked me up some weedy line, and
it's commercial grade.
This is his big claim to fame. It's commercial grade.
See, look, and it's square. See, look,
no, it's twisted. There's two of them there, twisted together. Can they see that it's twisted?
Yeah, there we go.
Well, the dark.
They picked it up for a second.
There you go.
Yeah, it's a little square. Twisted stuff.
But it works. We got it in the weedy. Oh, there they can see the twist.
Yeah. I was poking back.
Oops.
I don't know what I did.
Did you just cut us off?
No, I'm still playing. I don't know what I don't know what that stuff is.
Oh, I don't either. Okay.
Right click over there. Oh, there we go.
Okay, cool. So.
I almost messed it up.
Alright, anything else?
Yeah. If anybody has my $1 million in a beach house, you can send it to me at. Just in case one of our viewers is watching.
That owns one of those things that can just have a spare?
Forget the beach house, just go with $1 million. Heck, we'd sell for a dollar right now. Just $1 in the mail, I'd be happy. Mom, look at what I got!
Alright, anything else?
That would be an awesome podcast. Like, thank you for your contribution.
Thanks for the bucks, folks.
The contribution to Weedy Line.
Anyway, anything else? We're done.
I have a mustache.
He's just silly. He's gotta get ready to go to work. He doesn't want to. I'm going to Weedy.